The burial of the dead.
April is the cruelest month, breeding lilacs out of the dead land, mixing memory and desire, stirring dumb roots with spring rain. Winter kept us warm, covering earth in forgetful snow, feeding a little life with dried tubers. Summer surprised us coming over the Starnbergsee. With a shower of rain, we stopped in the colonnade and went on in sunlight into the Hofgarten and drank coffee and talked for an hour. You know,
Deutsch. And when we were children, staying at the Archduke's, my cousin's, he took us out in a sleigh and I was frightened. He said, Marie, hold on tight. And down we went. In the mountains there you feel free. I read much of the night and go south in the winter.
What are the roots that clutch? What branches grow out of this stony rubbish? Son of man, you cannot say or guess, for you know only a heap of broken images where the sun beats, and the dead tree gives no shelter, the cricket no relief, and the dry stone no sound of water. Only there is shadow under this red rock. Come in under the shadow of this red rock, and I will show you something different from either your shadow at morning striding behind you, or your shadow at evening rising to meet you. I will show you fear in a handful of dust.
Frisch weht der Wind, der Heimat zu. Mein irisch Kind, wo weilest du? You gave me hyacinths first a year ago. They called me the hyacinth girl, yet when we came back late from the hyacinth garden, your arms full and your hair wet, I could not speak. And my eyes failed. I was neither living nor dead, and I knew nothing. Looking into the heart of light.
Madame Sesostris, famous clairvoyant, had a bad cold. Nevertheless, is known to be the wisest woman in Europe with a wicked pack of cards.
Is your cold the drowned Phoenician sailor? Those are poles that were his Isaac. Here is Belladonna, the lady of the rocks, the lady of situations. Here is the man with three stones, and here the wheel. And here is the one-eyed merchant, and this card, which is blank, is something he carries on his back, which I am forbidden to see. I do not find the hanged man. Fear death by water. I see crowds of people walking round in a ring. Thank you. If you see dear Mrs. Equitone, tell her I'll bring the horoscope myself. One must be so careful these days.
So many, I had not thought death had undone so many. Sighs, short and infrequent, were exhaled, and each man fixed his eyes before his feet. Followed up the hill and down King William Street, to where St. Mary Woolnoth kept the hours with a dead sound on the final stroke of nine. There I saw one I knew, and stopped him, crying, Stetson, you who were with me in the ships at Mylai, that corpse you planted last year in your garden, has it begun to sprout? Will it bloom this year? Or has the sudden frost disturbed its bed? Oh, keep the dog far hence, that's friend to men, for with his nails he'll dig it up again. You hypocrite collector, mon semblable, mon frère.
The chair she sat in, like a burnished throne, glowed on the marble, where the glass held up by standards wrought with fruited vines, from which a golden cupidon peeked out. Another hid his eyes behind his wig. Doubled the flames of seven-branched candelabra, reflecting light upon the table as the glitter of her jewels rose to meet it from satin cases poured in rich profusion. In vials of ivory and colored glass unstoppered lurked her strange synthetic perfumes, unguent, powdered or liquid, troubled, confused, and drowned the sense in odors. Stirred by the air that freshened from the window, these ascended in fattening the prolonged candle flames, flung their smoke into the leque aria, stirring the pattern on the coffered ceiling. Huge sea wood, fed with copper, burned green and olive, framed by the colored stone, in which sad light carved dolphins swam. Above the antique mantle was displayed, as though a window gave upon the sylvan scene, the change of filmel by the barbarous king so rudely forced. Yet there the nightingale filled all the desert with inviolable voice, and still she cried, and still the world pursues, junk, junk, the dirty ears. And other withered stumps of time were told upon the wall. Staring forms leaned out, leaning, hushing the room enclosed. Footsteps shuffled on the stair. Under the firelight, under the brush, her hair spread out in fiery points, glowed into words, then would be savagely still.
My nerves are bad tonight. Yes, bad. Stay with me. Speak to me. Why do you never speak? Speak. What are you thinking of? What? Thinking? What? I never know what you're thinking. Think.
I think we are in Rat's Alley, where the dead men lost their fur.
What is that noise?
The wind under the door.
What is that noise now? What is the wind doing?
Nothing, again, nothing.
Do you know nothing? Do you see nothing? Do you remember nothing?
I remember those pearls that were his eyes.
Are you alive or not? Is there nothing in your head?
But no, 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 no. That Shakespearean rat. It's so elegant. Oh, it's
what shall I do now? What shall I do? I shall rush out as I am and walk the street with my hair down. So, what shall we do tomorrow? What shall we ever do?
The hot water at 10, and if it rains, a closed car at 4, and we shall play a game of chess, pressing lidless eyes and waiting for a knock upon the door.
When Lou's husband got demobbed, I said, I didn't mince my words, I said to her myself,
"Hurry up, please,
now Albert's coming back, make yourself a bit smart. You'll want to know what you've done with that money he gave you to get yourself some teeth. He did, I was there. You have them all out, Lou, and get a nice set," he said. "I swear I can't bear to look at you, and no more can't I," I said. "And think of poor Albert. He's been in the army 4 years. He wants a good time. And if you don't give it him, there's others that will," I said. "Oh, is there?" she said. "Something there," I said. "Then I'll know him to think," she said. And gave me a straight look. "If you don't like it, you can get on with it," I said. "Others can pick and choose if you can't. But if Albert makes off, it won't be for lack of telling. You ought to be ashamed," I said, "to look so antique." "And I'm only 31. I can't help it," she said, pulling a long face. "Same pills I took to bring it off," she said. She's had 5 already and nearly died of young George. "The chemist said it would be all right, but I've never been the same." "You are a proper fool," I said. "Well, if Albert won't leave you alone, there it is," I said. "What do you get married for if you don't want children?" Well, that Sunday, Albert was home, they had a hot gammon, and they asked me in to dinner to get the beauty of it hot. "Good night, Bill. Good night, Lou. Good night, May. Good night. Ta-ta, good night. Good night. Good night, ladies. Good night, sweet ladies. Good night. Good night."
Fingers leaf clutch and sink into the wet bank. The wind crosses the brown land unheard. The nymphs are departed. Sweet Thames, run softly till I end my song. The river bears no empty bottles, sandwich papers, silk handkerchiefs, cardboard boxes, cigarette ends, or other testimony of summer nights. The nymphs are departed. And their friends, the loitering heirs of city directors, departed but left no address. By the waters of Leman I sat down and wept. Sweet Thames, run softly till I end my song. Sweet Thames, run softly, for I speak not loud or long. But at my back, in a cold blast, I hear the rattle of the bones, and chuckle spread from ear to ear. A rat crept softly through the vegetation, dragging its slimy belly on the bank. While I was fishing in the dull canal, on a winter evening, round behind the gas house, musing upon the king, my brother's wreck, and on the king, my father's death before him. White bodies naked on a low, damp ground, and bones cast in a little, low, dry garret, rattled by the rats who told me year to year. But at my back, from time to time, I hear the sound of horns and motors, which shall bring Sweeney to Mrs. Porter in the spring. Oh, the moon shone bright on Mrs. Porter and on her daughter. They washed their feet in soda water. Et oh, ces voix d'enfants chantant dans la coupole. Twit, twit, twit. Jump, 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 jump.
So rudely forced.
Period.
Eugenides, Smanner Merchant, unshaven with a pocket full of currants, CIF London documents aside, asked me in demotic French to luncheon at the Cannon Street Hotel, followed by a weekend at the Metropole.
When the eyes and back turn upward from the desk, when the human engine waits like a taxi throbbing, waiting, I, Tiresias, though blind, throbbing between two lines, old man with wrinkled female breasts, can see at the violet hour, the evening hour that strides homeward and brings the sailor home from sea, the typist home at
tea time, kiss her breakfast, lights her stove, and lays out food and tins. The window perilously spread, her drying combinations touched by the sun's last rays. On the divan now piled at night, her bed, stockings, slippers, camisoles and stains.
I, Tiresias, old man with wrinkled dugs, perceived the scene and foretold the rest. I too awaited the expected guest. He, the young man carbuncular, arrives. A small house agent's clerk, with one bold stare, one of the low on whom assurance sits as a silk hat on a Bradford millionaire.
The time is now propitious, as he guesses. The meal is ended. She is bored and tired, endeavors to engage her in caresses, which still are unreproved, if undesired. Flushed and decided, he assaults at once. Exploring hands encounter no defense. His vanity requires no response, and makes a welcome of indifference.
I, Tiresias, have foresuffered all enacted on this same divan or bed. I, who have sat by Thebes below the wall, and walked among the lowest of the dead. Bestows one final patronizing kiss, and gropes his way, finding the stairs unlit.
She turns, and looks a moment in the glass, hardly aware of her departed lover. Her brain allows one half-formed thought to pass. Well, now that's done, I'm glad it's over. When lovely woman stoops to folly, and paces about the room again alone, she smooths her hair with automatic hand.
By me upon the waters, and along the strand, up Queen Victoria Street. Oh, city, city, I can sometimes hear, beside a public bar in Lower Thames Street, the pleasant whining of a mandolin, and a clatter and a chatter from within, where fishmen lounge at noon, where the walls of Magnus Martyr hold, inexplicable splendor of Ionian white. Barges drift with a turning tide, red sail wide to leeward. wash, drifting along, down Greenwich Beach, past the Isle of Dogs. La-ya-la-la, la-ya, la-la-la, la-ya-la-la. Elizabeth and Leicester, beating oars. The stern's form, the gilded shell, red and gold. The brisk swell rippled both shores. Southwest wind carried downstream the peal of bells, white towers. Va-la-la, la-ya, va-la-la, la-ya-la-la.
Trams and dusty trees. Highbury bore me. Richmond and Kew undid me. By Richmond, I raised my knees, supine on the floor of a narrow canoe. My feet are at Moorgate, my heart under my feet. After the event, he wept. He promised a new start. I made no comment. What should I resent? On Margate Sands, I can connect nothing. Fingernails of dirty hands, my people, humble people who expect nothing. La la!
To Carthage, then I came, burning, 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 burning. O Lord, thou pluckest me out. O Lord, thou pluckest. Burning.
Stages of his age and youth, entering the whirlpool. Gentile or Jew, O you who turn the wheel and look to windward, consider Phlebas, who was once handsome and tall as you.
Silence in the gardens, after the agony in stony places, the shouting, the crying, prison, palace, and reverberation, a thunderous spring over distant mountains. He who was living is now dead. We who were living are now dying with a little patience.
So I went to get the songs and protest in front of the White House.
Here is no water, but only rock. Rock. And no water, and the sandy road. The road winding above among the mountains, which are mountains of rock without water. If there were water, we should stop and drink. Amongst the rock, one cannot stop or think. Sweat is dry, and feet are in the sand. If there were only water amongst the rock, dead mountain mouth that carries teeth that cannot spit. Here one can neither stand, nor lie, nor sit. There is not even silence in the mountains, but dry, sterile thunder without rain. There is not even solitude in the mountains, but red, sullen faces sneer and snarl from the doors of mud-cracked houses.
I'm drunk with bloodshed, and adultery is that great city that talks about Revelation 17.
There were water and no rock. If there were rock and also water, and water a spring, a pool among the rock, if there was the sound of water only, not the cicada and dry grass singing, but sound of water over a rock, where the hermit thrush sings. Drip-lop. Drip-lop. Drop. Drop. But there is no water.
Sick and filthy capital. They are the most satanic organization on the face of planet Earth and have absolutely nothing to do with the Lord Jesus Christ. Nobody slaughtered, slayed, murdered.
Who is the third who walks always beside you? When I count, there are only you and I together, but when I look ahead up the white road, there is always another one walking beside you, gliding, wrapped in a brown mantle, hooded. I do not know whether a man or a woman, but who is that on the other side of you?
What is that sound high in the air? Murmur of nocturnal lamentation. Who are those hooded hordes swarming over endless plains, stumbling in cracked earth, ringed by the flat horizon only? What is the city over the mountains, cracks and reforms and bursts in the violet air? Falling towers, Jerusalem, Athens, Alexandria, Vienna, London, and Hill.
And the limp leaves waited for rain while the black clouds gathered far distant over Himalaya. The jungle crouched, humped in silence. Then spoke the thunder.
Da.
Data.
What have we given?
my friend, blood shaking my heart. The awful daring of a moment's surrender, which an age of prudence can never retract. By this and this only we have existed, which is not to be found in our obituaries, or in memories draped by the beneficent spider, or under seals broken by the lean solicitor in our empty rooms. Da.
Die, Advan. I have heard the key turn in the door once, and turn once only. We think of the key, each in his prison, thinking of the key. Each confirms a prison only at nightfall. Ethereal rumors revive for a moment a broken Coriolanus.
Responded gaily to the hand, expert with sail and oar. The sea was calm. Your heart would have responded gaily when invited, beating obedient to controlling hands.
I sat upon the shore, fishing with the arid plain. Shall I at least set my lands in order? London Bridge is falling down, falling down. Poesas, cose nel foco che gli affina. Quando fiam uti che li don, oh swallow, swallow. Quans dacquiten a la tour aboni. These fragments I have shored against my will. Why then, I'll fit you. Hieronymo's mad again. Yatta. Dayadva.
Dayadva.
Damyatta.
Damyatta.
Shanti. 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 Shanti.